So today we are starting with unsolved numerical from kinetic theory of gases and radiation. Okay, these are unsolved numericals from textbooks. So we are starting with number 11. Now here, calculate the ratio of mean square speeds of molecules of a gas at 30 Kelvin and 120 Kelvin. Okay, this type of numerical can be asked to you for 2 marks. Okay, what is asked to calculate here? Ratio of mean square speeds molecule of gas is given at temperature 30 degree and 120 degree. Okay, so we already know here the formula, that is root mean square velocity square of root mean square velocity, that is V RMS square is equal to 3 RT upon M. This we already know, so we can write here V1 and V2 notations for molecule of gas at 30 degree and 120 degree. Okay, so we will be taking here V1 square, that will be equal to 3 R T1 upon M. Okay, R is gas constant, so we are not taking R1, R2, that will be same here, and M, capital M here will be same because we are taking here molecule of gas. Okay, that is a single gas we are taking, same gas we are taking. Only temperature we are considering here 30 degree and 30 Kelvin and 120 Kelvin. Okay, M is here molar mass. Okay, so 3 RT upon M. So we are taking ratio V1 upon V2. So 3 R T1 upon M, 3 R T2 upon M. Okay, so 3 R upon M you can cancel here. Only we will be here. Remaining here will be T1 upon T2. So V1 upon V2 will be equal to T1 upon T2. You can put value here. So 30 by 120 temperature. V1 we are taking here for temperature 30 Kelvin. So V1. So here we will be taking 30 divided by 120. So that is actually 1 by 4. Okay. So that is your answer. This is the ratio of same physical quantity. So there will be no unit. Next here, 12 number. Two vessels A and B are filled with same gas where volume, temperature and pressure in vessel A is twice the volume, temperature and pressure in vessel B. Calculate the ratio of molecules of gas in vessel A to that in vessel B. Okay, so here it is given here volume for the vessel A is equal to 2 times of volume for the vessel B. Similarly here TA is equal to 2 times TB. PA equal to 2 times PB, because here it is given volume, temperature and pressure for vessel A is twice the volume, temperature and pressure for vessel B. Okay, now here we already know PV is equal to NKT. This K suffix P is nothing but Boltzmann constant. Okay, so number of molecule capital N we can write here as PV upon KBT. Okay, K suffix B into T. Okay, so for suppose we are defining here this same quantity for vessel A and for vessel B, so we can write here suffix A and suffix B here. Okay, so NA is equal to P suffix A, V suffix A, that is PA, VA. KB we are taking same for both because KB is nothing but Boltzmann constant, that will be constant for vessel A and vessel B. Okay, temperature here we are taking as TA. Similarly here for vessel B we can write NB is equal to PBVB divided by KBTB. Okay, so here it is asked to calculate the ratio of number of molecule of gas in vessel A to that in vessel B, that is NA upon NB. This is asked to calculate here, so we will divide here NA upon NB. Okay, so we are here dividing this whole term, dividing by this whole term. Okay, so here we can separate pressure, volume and temperature. Okay, this KB, that is Boltzmann constant, will get cancelled. When we are dividing, it will get cancelled. Okay, so P upon PB we will be getting V upon VB, TB upon TA, because this B, TB is in denominator, TA is in denominator. So here we will be getting as TB upon TA, right? Okay, so this we can put values here. P upon PB, here you can see P upon PB, if you are writing, that is actually 2. Okay, similarly VA upon VB will be 2, and here TB upon TA will be 1 by 2. So we are putting value 2 2 1 by 2. 1 2 you can cancel here, that is 2 and 2 you will cancel, only 2 is left here. So this ratio we are getting, that is required ratio we are getting as 2 upon 1. Okay, that is your final answer. Next, 13 number. A gas in a cylinder at pressure P. A gas in a cylinder is at pressure P. If the mass of all molecules are made one third of either original value and their speeds are double, then find the resultant pressure. Okay, so what is given here? M2 is equal to M1 by 3, that is mass is here one third of original value. Suppose we are taking original value as M1, so M2 will be equal to M1 by 3. Similarly here, their speeds are double means you will consider Vrms2 is equal to 2 times Vrms1. Okay, so this is given here. So we already know the pressure formula from the derivation. P is equal to 1 by 3 Nm upon V. Okay, so this Nm upon V, this capital V is volume and Vrms square. Okay, this is root mean square velocity, square of the value. So if you are defining P1 and P2, that is for initial and final state or initial and final value, you can write P1 is equal to 1 by 3 here M1 N divided by Vrms1 square. Okay, so this number of molecule here is same, volume is same. Okay, so only change here is M1 and Vrms square 1. Okay, suffix 1 here we are taking, here we will be taking suffix 2. So P2 is equal to 1 by 3 M2 N by Vrms2 square. Okay, then you will take a ratio because it is asked to calculate the final pressure, that is P2 we are expected to calculate. So we can write P2 upon P1, then you will shift P1 value to other side. Okay, so P2 upon P1, if you are dividing, we can get 1 by 3, 1 by 3 will get cancelled, capital N will get cancelled, this capital V will get cancelled. So remaining here will be M2 upon M1, and here it will be Vrms2 square divided by Vrms1 square, right? And M2 value we already knew, that is M1 upon 3. So we'll put here M2 as M1 upon 3. Again M1, M1 you can cancel. This value we already know, Vrms2 square will be equal to 2 times Vrms2 is equal to 2 times Vrms1. Okay, so Vrms2 upon Vrms1 will be 2. And here square of the value, so it will be 2 square, right? So 2 square. So we are getting 4 by 3, okay? P1, then you will shift to other side. Therefore, P2 will be equal to 4 by 3 into P1, okay? So your final answer, suppose we are taking initial pressure because it is given, initial pressure is capital P, not P1. So we can here replace the notation. So 4 by 3 P, this is your resultant pressure, okay? Next. That RMS velocity of an oxygen molecule is root 2 times that of sulfur dioxide molecule at STP. STP means standard temperature and pressure. Okay, so what you are supposed to write here? VRMS velocity of oxygen is root 2 times the VRMS velocity of sulfur dioxide. This is, you will prove the relation. Okay, so we already know here that M0, that is molecular mass upon M0, molecular mass of sulfur divided by molecular mass of oxygen. So 64 kilogram per mole divided by 32 kilogram per mole. So that will be actually 2. You will, if you are dividing, we are getting 2. Vrms velocity, that is, we already know, is square root 3RT upon M0. Okay, so that is, this numerator we can consider as constant, this is gas constant, temperature will be absolute temperature. Suppose we consider temperature is constant, so variable here will be M0 only. So we can write Vrms is inversely proportional to square root of M0, okay, at constant temperature. So if you are writing this formulas for O2 and SO2, so we can write Vrms O2 divided by Vrms SO2 is equal to root of M0 SO2 divided by M0 O2. Okay, so we already know here, we already calculated the ratio as 2, so we will put here value as 2, so we are getting root 2, right? So we can write VRMS of oxygen is equal to root 2 times VRMS of sulfur dioxide. So this is the relation which is here asked to prove, okay? At what temperature will oxygen molecule have same RMS speed as helium molecule as at HTP? Okay, so again it is given, temperature of oxygen is asked to calculate. Okay, so oxygen molecule have same RMS speed as helium, that is both are having same RMS speed here. Okay, now here it is given, here molecular mass of oxygen and helium are 32 and 4. Okay, so here STP means standard temperature pressure, so we can write T2 is equal to 273 Kelvin. M01, that is molecular mass of oxygen, we are taking 32, it is in gram, right? So we can convert it in kilogram, so 32 into 10 raised to minus 3 kilogram per mole. Similarly, molecular mass of hydrogen will be M02, that is 4 into 10 raised to minus 3 kilogram per mole. VRMS velocity formula is square root 3RT upon M0. This we already know. We can define this VRMS velocity for oxygen molecule as V1. So V1 is equal to square root 3RT1 upon M01. Okay. Similarly here, and this is, that is both VRMS velocities are equal here. So V1 is equal to 3RT2 upon M02. This is in square root, that is both V1 and V2 are equal. So we can write, instead of this V2, we can write as V1. That is, we will equate here. Okay. So square root, you can cancel, 3R, you can cancel here. So remaining here will be T1 upon M01, T2 upon M02. So T1 is equal to, because temperature of oxygen molecule asked to calculate. So T1 is equal to, you can shift this M01 to other side. So we are getting M01 divided by M02 into T2. Okay. So here 32 into 10 raised to minus 3 divided by 4 into 10 raised to minus 3 multiplied by 273. 10 raised to minus 3 you will cancel. 32 divided by 4 you will be getting as 8. 8 into 273 you can manually multiply, and answer we are getting as 2184. Here unit will be Kelvin because we are writing temperature. So SI unit will write here as Kelvin. So 2184 Kelvin, this is your final answer. Next, compare the RMS speed of hydrogen molecule at 127 degree Celsius with RMS speed of oxygen molecule at 27 degree Celsius. Given that molecular mass of hydrogen and oxygen are 2 and 32 respectively. So molecular mass of hydrogen we can write as M01 as 2 gram per mole. M02 for oxygen as 32 gram per mole. T1 for hydrogen, it is here given as 127 degree Celsius. You can convert in Kelvin. So we are adding 273. So 273 plus 127, that is 400 Kelvin. T1 for oxygen, 273 plus 27, that is 300 Kelvin. So RMS velocity is equal to square root 3RT upon M0, right? So we will divide VRMS of hydrogen divided by VRMS of oxygen. So 3R we will cancel here, that will be constant for both here. So 3R you will cancel. You can write here T1 upon T2, okay? And here for M0, you can write M02 upon M01. Putting values here, T1 is 400, T2 is 300, M02 here is 32, M01 is 2. Both zeros you can cancel here, 2 and 4 you can cancel, so we'll be getting here 2. 2 into 32 and divide by 3 here, okay? So we can write it as, okay, we are taking zeros, we can cancel here. This 2 you will divide 32 by 2, so that is 16. So 4 by 3 into 16. You can take here square root. So square root of 4 will be 2. Square root of 16 will be 4. And this root 3 we are writing as it is, okay, root 3. So this is 8 by root 3, 2 into 4 will be 8. 8 upon root 3, this is your final answer. Okay, next. 17 number, find the kinetic energy of 5 liter of gas at STP. Given standard pressure is 1.013 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per meter square. 5 liter of gas at STP, pressure aapko diya hua hai. 1.013 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per meter square. So pressure we are taking same value, volume we are taking 5 liter. 5 liter you can convert into meter cube, so we will multiply by 5 into 10 raised to minus 3. Okay, so multiply by 10 raised to minus 3 so that it will be converted into meter cube. Now here kinetic energy, that is average value of kinetic energy, is equal to 3 by 2 PV. You can put here value 3 by 2. Pressure 1.013 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per meter square. And volume we can write 5 into 10 raised to minus 3. Okay. So you can solve here. So this 10 raised to 5 and 10 raised to minus 3, it will be 10 raised to 2. Okay, so you are writing as 10 raised to 2. Now next, this 1.013 we are writing as it is. This 3 by 2 and this is your 5. Okay, so 3 into 5 will be 15, 15 by 2 will be 7.5. so 7.5 into 1.013 into 10 raised to 2. You can multiply 7.5 into 1.013. This you can multiply manually. Our answer here will be 7.597 into 10 raised to 2 as it is we are writing. As we are calculating your kinetic energy, SI unit will be joule. So this is your required value. Calculate the average molecular kinetic energy. Number 1. Per mole, number 2 per kilogram, number 3 per molecule of oxygen at 127 degree Celsius. Given that molecular weight of oxygen is 32. Capital R gas constant is given as 8.31 joule per mole Kelvin. Avogadro's number is given as 6.02302 into 10 raised to 23 molecule per mole. So temperature here we will consider. Temperature is given as 127 degree Celsius. We will convert in Kelvin. So T is equal to 273 plus 127, that is 400 Kelvin. Molecular weight is 32. Molar mass will be here 32 kilogram per kilomole. Okay. R value, capital R, it is given here as 8.31 joule per mole per Kelvin. Avogadro's number is given 6.02 into 10 raised to 23 molecule per mole. So for first sub question, average kinetic energy per kilomole, we can write here as per kilomole of oxygen is equal to average kinetic energy per mole of oxygen into 1000, right? Kilomole we are converting into mole, so we will multiply by 1000. So formula you will write 3 by 2 RT into 1000. 3 by 2 R value 8.31, T is 400. This 1000 is nothing but 10 raised to 3, right? Okay, so you will solve all these numbers. That is, this we are taking 8.31 as it is. Okay, this 400 divided by 2 will be 200. 200 into 3 will be 600. So 600 into 8.31 is 10 raised to 3 as it is we are writing. Okay, now next. We can shift here decimal point, so you can write here as 0.6 into 10 raised to 3, okay, and this 10 raised to 3, so that will be 10 raised to 6. 0.6 so you can multiply by 8.31, so answer here will be 4.986, and this 10 raised to 3 into 10 raised to 3, 10 raised to 6. Here unit will be joule per kilomole, right, because we converted here, okay. So joule per kilomole. Next sub question here, that is average molecular kinetic energy per kilogram of oxygen. Okay, now here you can write 3 by 2 RT upon M0. This is formula for average molecular kinetic energy per kilogram. Okay, so we are dividing by M0. So this we already calculated, 3 by 2 RT we already calculated as this value. So this value as it is we are using from sub question number 1. So 4.986 into 10 raised to 6 joule per mole divided by 32 kilogram per kilomole. Okay, now here you can divide this number by 32. Okay, shifting the decimal to one digit, that is 10 raised to 6, we are writing as 10 raised to 5. So we are getting 1.558 into 10 raised to 5. Unit here will be joule per kilogram. Okay, joule per kilogram, because we will cancel this per mole, this kilomole we will write as 1000 divided by mole. Okay, after shifting the decimal, your answer will be 1.558 into 10 raised to 5 joule per kilogram. Okay, next sub question here is average molecular kinetic energy per molecule of oxygen. Per molecule means you will divide 3 by 2 RT divided by Avogadro's number n suffix a. Okay, so this we already know, 3 by 2 RT value is 4.986 into 10 raised to 6 joule per mole. Avogadro's number we will consider as 6.02 into 10 raised to 23 molecule per mole. Okay, so per mole you will cancel. So finally unit will be joule per molecule, and here you will solve, that is 10 raised to 23, 10 raised to 6 here. Okay, you will shift the decimal, you will divide the values. So finally we are getting answer as 8.282 into 10 raised to minus 21, okay, joule per molecule. Next, 19 number, calculate the energy radiated in 1 minute by a black body of surface area 100 centimeter square when it is maintained at 227 degrees Celsius. So time here is given as 1 minute. 1 minute means 60 seconds. Area is 100 centimeter square. You can convert this centimeter square into meter square. Okay, so if you are converting centimeter into meter, we will multiply by 10 raised to minus 2 here. So centimeter square, if you are converting in meter square, we will multiply by 10 raised to minus 2 square, that is 10 raised to minus 4. So 100 into 10 raised to minus 4 meter square. Okay, so this is 10 raised to plus 2, 10 raised to minus 4. So this is 10 raised to minus 2 meter square. Temperature is 227 degrees Celsius, we will convert in Kelvin. So 273 plus 227, 500 Kelvin. Okay, sigma is nothing but Stefan's constant, which is already considered as constant. So value here is 5.67 into 10 raised to minus 8 watt per meter square per Kelvin raised to 4. So energy radiated formula here will be according to Stefan's law of radiation. Q is equal to sigma A T raised to 4 into T. Okay, so here sigma value 5.67 into 10 raised to minus 8. This capital A is 10 raised to minus 2. T raised to 4 is 500 raised to 4. T is 60. Okay, you will solve all these terms. Okay, so this 10 raised to minus 8, 10 raised to minus 2 will be minus 10, and this 00 raised to 4, that is 10 raised to 2 raised to 10 raised to 2 raised to 4, that is 10 raised to 8. So this 10 raised to plus 8 and minus 8 you can cancel. This 500 you can write as 5 into 10 raised to 2. And raised to 4 lena hai, toh 5 raised to 4 directly hum yahan likh sakte hain as 625. 5.67 as it is likha hai, 5 raised to 4 ko humne likha hai 625. 60 ko as it is likha hua hai. Ye jo 0 zeros ka raised to 4 lena hai, that is 10 raised to 2 ka 4th power, wo hoga 10 raised to 8. So 10 raised to plus 8 and 10 raised to minus 8 cancel kar sakte hain. So 10 raised to minus 2 as it is likhna hai. Theek hai? So after multiplying all these, we will be getting answer as 2126 joule. Okay, SI unit here for your answer will be joule, because we are calculating energy radiated. Okay, next number. Energy is emitted from a hole in an electric furnace at the rate of 20 watt. When the temperature of furnace is 727 degree Celsius, what is the area of hole? Stefan's constant ka value aapko already diya hua hai, 5.7 into 10 raised to minus 8 joule per second meter square kelvin raised to 4. So aapko diya hai rate, that is 20 watt, that is nothing but q by t, because watt jo hota hai wo power ke liye hota hai. Power kya hoga? Q upon t hoga. Okay, so q upon t is 20 watt. Temperature 727 ko hum kelvin mein convert kar denge. So 273 plus 727 will be 1000 kelvin. Sigma ye already aapko diya hua hai. Formula you can use q by t is equal to sigma into a into t raised to 4. आपको निकालना है एरिया ऑफ होल, दैट इज कैपिटल ए कैलकुलेट करना है. तो अननोन को हम लेफ्ट में शिफ्ट कर देंगे. सो ए इज इक्वल टू क्यू बाई टी अपॉन सिग्मा टी रेस टू 4. ओके, क्यू बाई टी 20 ऑलरेडी दिया हुआ है. सिग्मा का वैल्यू हमने पुट कर दिया 5.7 इंटू 10 रेस टू माइनस 8. टी रेस टू 4, दैट इज 1000 का रेस टू 4 आपको लेना है. सो दैट विल बी 10 रेस टू 7, राइट. हमने क्या किया यहाँ पे, सी हियर 20 एज इट इज रखा है, 5.7 नीचे एज इट इज रखा हुआ है, ठीक है. ये जो है 1000 रेस टू 4, दैट इज एक्चुअली 12 इंटू 10 रेस टू प्लस 12, 10 रेस टू माइनस 8, दैट विल बी 10 रेस टू प्लस 4. 10 रेस टू प्लस 4 को ऊपर शिफ्ट कर देंगे तो 10 रेस टू माइनस 4 लेंगे. ओके, उसके बाद आपने 20 डिवाइडेड बाय 5.7 ये सॉल्व करना है. आंसर आपको मिलेगा 3.509. 10 रेस टू माइनस 4 एज इट इज पुट किया हुआ है. सो एरिया वी आर गेटिंग एज 3.509 इंटू 10 रेस टू माइनस 4 मीटर स्क्वायर. ओके, नेक्स्ट. द इमिसिव पावर ऑफ अ स्फीयर ऑफ एरिया 0.02 मीटर स्क्वायर इज 0.5 किलो कैलोरी पर सेकेंड मीटर स्क्वायर. वॉट इज द अमाउंट ऑफ हीट रेडिएटेड बाय द स्फेरिकल सर्फेस इन 20 सेकेंड. सो हियर इट इज गिवन the emissive power, that is capital R, is given as 0.5 kilo calorie per second per meter square. Capital A area is given as 0.02 meter square. Time here is given as 20 second. Okay, so formula here will be Q is equal to R A into T. Okay, so heat radiated, Q is equal to R A into T. You will put values here, 0.5 into 0.02 into 20. Okay, 0.5 means 1 by 2, अगर आप 20 को 2 से डिवाइड कर देते हो, यू विल बी गेटिंग 10. 10 इंटू 0.02 यू विल मल्टीप्लाई, सो यू विल शिफ्ट द डेसिमल हियर. सो 0.2 किलो कैलोरी, दिस इज योर फाइनल आंसर. नेक्स्ट इज कंपेयर द रेट ऑफ इमिशन बाय अ ब्लैक बॉडी मेंटेन्ड एट 727 डिग्री एंड 227 डिग्री. इफ ब्लैक बॉडीज आर सराउंडेड बाय एनक्लोजर at 27 degrees Celsius, what would be the ratio of rate of loss of heat? So T1 आपको दिया हुआ है 727, we will convert in Kelvin. So 273 plus 727, that is 1000 Kelvin. T2 is 227 degrees Celsius, you will add 273, so we are getting as 500 Kelvin. Surrounding temperature is given as 27, you will convert again in Kelvin. So 273 plus 27, that is 300 Kelvin. Formula for rate of emission we will be taking as dQ by dt. Sigma A into 10 t raised to 4. So suffix 1 and 2 you will divide, dQ by dt suffix 1, dQ by dt suffix 2. Okay, so here sigma A will get cancelled for both. So T1 raised to 4 by T2 raised to 4. Okay, so you will put here values 1000 by 500. So we are getting 2 raised to 4, that is nothing but 16 here. Next is rate of loss of heat dQ by dt. Again, we will be taking, because we consider now temperature of surrounding. So we'll be writing equation as sigma A T raised to 4 minus T0 raised to 4. Okay, so again, we are repeating here suffix 1, suffix 2. T1 raised to 4 minus T0 raised to 4. Again T2 raised to 4 minus T0 raised to 4. Sigma upon a sigma a divided by sigma a, you will cancel here. So you will put all the values here. So 10 raised to 12, okay, that is 1000 raised to 3 will be 10 raised to 12 minus. Surrounding temperature is 300, okay. So 300 raised to 4 here you will write as 81 into 10 raised to 8. Similarly, T2 raised to 4, T2 temperature here is 500. 500 raised to 4 will be 625 into 10 raised to 8. Again, surrounding temperature minus 81 into 10 raised to 8. 10 raised to 8 you will take common here from numerator and denominator. So remaining here will be 10,000 minus 81, okay, and here 544. So 10 raised to 8 you will cancel. After taking difference here, 10,000 minus 81, we are getting 9,919 divided by 544. You will solve this. You can use log calculation. Your answer will be 18.23, okay. Next, Earth's mean temperature can be assumed to be 280 Kelvin. How will the curve of blackbody radiation look like for the temperature? Find out lambda max. In which part of the electromagnetic spectrum does this value lie? Okay, so temperature of Earth, it is given as 280 Kelvin. Wien's constant aapko consider karna hai, that is 2.897 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter Kelvin. So lambda max, because aapko lambda max diya hai, means you will apply Wien's law. Okay, so lambda max into T is equal to B. So lambda max will be B upon T. B value, that is Wien's constant, it is given. So 2.897 into 10 raised to minus 3 divided by 280. Okay, you will solve this. You can use log calculation here. So your answer finally you will be getting as 1.035 into 10 raised to minus 5 meter. Okay, and for this value of wavelength, that is lambda max value, if you are locating this value in the electromagnetic spectrum, we are getting infrared region. Okay, so this value will lie in infrared region, and the nature of the black body radiation will be same jaisa hum consider karte hain, asymmetric bell shaped curve, but the maximum value will occur at 1.035 into 10 raised to minus 5 meter. Okay, next, a small blackened solid copper sphere of radius 2.5 centimeter is placed in evacuated chamber. The temperature of chamber is maintained as 100 degrees Celsius. At what rate energy must be supplied to the copper sphere to maintain its temperature as at 110 degrees Celsius? So aapko sigma value diya hua hai, theek hai? Sigma, it is given 5.76 into 10 raised to minus 8 joule per second meter square Kelvin raised to 4. Okay, so we are taking sigma value as same. Now here radius is 2.5 centimeter, you will convert in meter. So 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 2 meter. Surrounding temperature is 100 degrees Celsius, we will convert in Kelvin. So 273 plus 100, that is 373 Kelvin. Temperature here, it is given as 110. So 110 plus 273, that is 383 Kelvin. Okay, so the rate at which energy is supplied, so in rate you will consider as sigma a T raised to 4 minus T0 raised to 4. This a, because aapko diya hua hai spherical shape, so a surface area will be 4 pi r square. Okay, so sigma 4 pi r square T raised to 4 minus T0 raised to 4. This one you will calculate here. Sigma value you are putting as 5.67 into 10 raised to minus 8. 4 as it is, pi value 3.14, r square will be 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 2 bracket square, T raised to 4 will be 383 raised to 4 minus 373 raised to 4. Okay, so we are getting this power of 10, you can collect here. So this will be here 10 raised to minus 8, this will be here 10 raised to minus 4, 10 raised to minus 8, 10 raised to minus 4. Okay, this 5.67 as it is we are writing 4 3.14, you can write it as 3.14 or 3.142. This 2.5 square will be 6.25. Okay. Now here, this powers, that is raised to 4, you can write as 3.83 raised to 4 minus 3.73 raised to 4. What we did here, we are shifting the decimal point. You can see here. तो दो डिजिट आपने शिफ्ट किया हुआ है, दैट इज 10^2. 10^2 का फोर्थ पावर क्या आएगा? 10^8, राइट. सो ये 10^+8 और ये 10^-8 आप कैंसिल कर सकते हो. ओके, 10^-2 का स्क्वायर होगा 10^-4, जो कि हमने एज इट इज रखा है. ठीक है, आफ्टर सॉल्विंग ऑल दीज वैल्यूज आवर आंसर विल बी 0.9624 वैट. ओके, बिकॉज रेट ऑफ एनर्जी वी आर कैलकुलेटिंग, यूनिट हियर विल बी वैट और यू विल राइट जूल पर सेकेंड. ओके, नाउ हियर लास्ट वन हियर इज फाइंड द टेम्परेचर ऑफ ब्लैक बॉडी इफ इट्स स्पेक्ट्रम हैज पीक एट. तो आपको 3 सब क्वेश्चन दिया हुआ है. फर्स्ट लेना है लैम्डा मैक्स 700 नैनोमीटर, दैट इज विजिबल रेंज. फॉर फर्स्ट वन 700 नैनोमीटर यू कैन कन्वर्ट इन मीटर, 700 × 10^-9 meter. Okay, this formula is common, lambda max into t is equal to b. So t here will be b upon lambda max. B is Wien's constant. We will take value as 2.897 × 10^-3 meter Kelvin divided by 700 × 10^-9. Okay, so after solving, our answer here will be 4138 Kelvin. For second sub-question, 3 centimeter. So 3 centimeter is nothing but 3 × 10^-2 meter. That is B, you will divide by 3 × 10^-2. Okay. So our answer here will be 9.66 × 10^-2 Kelvin. Last here is 3 meter. Okay. Lambda max here is 3 meter. So 3 meter, you will divide by 3. Value we are dividing by 3. So we are getting as 9.66 × 10^-4 Kelvin. So this is all about 4 numericals from textbook.